Hi. Let's see if my AirPods. Y'all can hear me? Perfect. All right. Happy February. Happy Groundhog Day. Happy Black History Month. happy Tuesday. We'll give it a few moments. But yeah, if y'all want to share anything, feel free. Oh, you're muted. I don't know if y'all are talking to me, but
It's snowing. I'm shocked.
yes, I love it. It is.
Yeah.
Yes.
So beautiful,
No,
but
I mean, I love snow.
it does put a limit in what you can do
Yeah, you're right.
outside.
Yes. I know. I'm like, are you running? Probably not. Are you running in this?
I bought a treadmill.
I don't know. You're pretty serious about the running.
I bought from Amy a discounted spin bike, and we have an elliptical, so we never have to go anywhere.
Oh, that's amazing. See, I low key want to get one. Because I am never outside anymore. Huh?
Yeah, but we shoveled yesterday a little bit, but then it
Well,
snowed
the wheat
again,
is
so
king.
to no
Yes.
avail.
Yes. It's really nice. It's
Yeah.
like looking out the window and I feel like I'm in my own snow globe.
Yeah, kind of.
Yes.
It's like
Yeah.
gently trickling down from
Yeah.
above.
As we
Yeah.
sit here and look, we
Yeah.
see it coming down very gently.
Yeah.
Yes. It's very meditative, I
Yeah.
would say, relaxing.
Yeah.
But yeah, cool. Hi, Sarah. Thanks for joining. Let
Hello.
me,
Thanks for having me.
yeah, of course.
Sorry,
Every
my computer does
Tuesday.
not like my camera to be on for lengthy periods of time, so I'm gonna have to be camera off so
Oh,
that my
that's all
computer
good.
doesn't explode.
That's all good. I just want to promote cozy vibes, especially now that it's winter time. And like, I'm like, I don't always have to wear yoga pants. I don't always have to wear a fitness top. So, I'm bringing yoga and sweatpants today, and that's just an invitation for y'all to do that as well. Wear your PJs if you'd like. You can keep your camera off at any point. And I'm going to do my best since this does go up to YouTube to keep myself pinned so that I can honor y'all's privacy and stuff. But yeah, if there's ever anything, let me know. I can take the extra time to edit stuff out. But welcome. Let's go ahead and get started. Energetically, are y'all like, I'm up here. Okay, yeah, we're pretty good vibes. Okay.
Medium.
Medium. Okay, some of us medium. Hey, Natasha. Well, I just always like starting seated. It's just grounding. And let's go ahead and do that. And at any point that you cannot hear me, let me know. But I'm going to start playing some music just to set the vibes. And it will be pinned on me. So you don't have to worry if you'll be shown on YouTube. Okay. So eyes are closed. Find your comfortable seat. Bring the shoulders back and down. And bring the ears back a few inches. And keep your chin parallel with the floor. We have a tendency to lift up here. Yeah, so we'll just spend 3 minutes arriving. Just notice a drop in the shoulders and at the same time, a lengthening through the spine. Really letting the belly expand on the inhale. And letting it fall away, letting go of any expectations for today's practice. And let's just invite the concept of curiosity and exploration. not only on the mat, but even off the mat. Softening in the face and the jaw and around the eyes, even the fingers and the wrists, letting them just let go and breathing at your own pace. Bringing your attention to your body, your space, the temperature in the room. The clothes on your skin. Perhaps bringing the imagery of a snow globe. If you're on the East Coast or wherever you are, if there's snow. And using that as a metaphor for finding calmness. That outside is the snow globe. And we can control our nervous system if we're revved up or if we need to calm down. Sometimes we need to shake things up. So go ahead and just set your intention for today's practice of how can you be a bit more curious? Maybe it's bringing a beginner's mind to the yoga mat. Deep breath in through the nose. Deep breath out, and a few more times. Good, and then slowly flutter the eyes open, coming back to the space. And I'm gonna play a little bit more upbeat track as we move on our mat. Perfect. Cool, cool, cool. Let's just rock side to side, lifting the hip bones off the earth. Good, inhale, reach the arms up. Woo, shoulders down. Exhale, palms away. Let's just build momentum. Inhale, reach. Exhale. One more. Inhale, lift. Exhale, palms together, coming down. I have a pretty much standard way of starting yoga practices. So bring the fingertips to the earth, just a great way, especially when we're working from home, opening up in the neck and the shoulders, reaching those fingertips away from you. Breathing into the sensation here. Good, inhale, lift up. Let's switch, other fingertips down. Exhale, pull away. And create more space. Good, inhale, lift up through center. Hopefully you feel a little longer. And then we'll just set same arm. You're gonna continue a side bend, stretch. So notice how the sit bones stay into the earth and I don't just plop my arms. There's continuous reaching and this elbow can come down and you can look towards the forearm on the floor, or maybe you can turn the face up towards the sky. Reach, reach, reach. Inhale, slowly lift up through center. Nice. Can you take up more space? Exhale. All the way. Keep reaching through. I'm getting longer. It's like someone's pulling these fingertips. Good. Look to the earth. And then look towards your arm. Good, inhale. Reach up and to center, cool. So actually, this doesn't matter. Inhale, reach the arms up. Let's take our first twist. Inhale, exhale, opposite hand to the knee. Look over the back shoulder. Sit up tall. Breathe. Inhale, lift through center. Woo! Good. Exhale, twist the other way. Good. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, palms together. Good. And then let's take the tops of the hands and just kind of press a little bit. And you can play here, keeping the connection of the fingers. Go back to prayer. I'm a dancer too, so I like to do little finger tutting. See if you can find that articulation through the hands. Hey, I love it. Good, press the palms out. Roll the wrist. Reverse. Jazz fingers, fist. And then rock forward to your first tabletop of today's practice. Good. Knees directly underneath those hips, hands directly underneath those shoulders. Spread the fingers wide. And let's take our favorite cow cats, drop the belly. Inhale, look up. Exhale, scoop the navel in, round in the spine. Press away from the earth. Two more, drop the belly. Inhale, cow. Exhale, scoop the navel in. Press away from the earth. And one more. I would climb. And exhale. Inside a red balloon floating towards good. From here, step your feet back into your first plank. So press away from the mat, around in the upper back. If this plank doesn't feel good, you can drop the knees or take a forearm plank. But if you're here, start to rock forward and back on those toes. Feel this in the abdominals, in the upper body. Ooh, breathe. Good. Exhale, drop the knees down to the earth. We're going to take a half push-up. So I'm going to take my elbows. I know you can't tell in this hoodie, but they're going to rotate in. And you're going to keep your elbows back as you lower your body down to the mat. Yeah, release the feet. Inhale, lift up cobra, pulling the shoulders down. Exhale, release. Tuck the toes, press back up to your plank. And rock forward and back again, building some heat here. Keep the spine nice and long. And then reach forward, drop the knees, draw the elbows in, lower your upper body down to the mat. Release. Release the feet, wiggle the hips. Inhale, lift up cobra or upward facing dog. And then exhale, this time, scooch the hips back, sink the hips back all the way, rest your forehead down. Give your wrists a little break. Soften and let go here. Then let's walk our hands to the left side of the mat. Right hand on top to pull the right shoulder blade back. Soften in your face and in your jaw. Good. And then walk the fingertips to the right side of the mat. Left hand on top. Sink the hips back. Feel that stretch in the left shoulder. Good, and then walk the fingertips to the center of the mat. This time, come back to your table, and then exhale, lift the hips up high. Meet me in your plank again. This time, we're gonna rock to the edges of our feet here. See how that feels in the abdominals. Yep, so keeping my hips where they're at, and I just rock side to side, nice and slow. Careful with the toesies. Good, one more. Nice, back to your plank. Drop the knees down and then all the way down to the earth. Woo. This time reach your fingertips off the mat and to the side, press into the finger pads. Here we go, little wave. Inhale, lift up. That is the last thing. Exhale, release. Two more. Press into the finger pads. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, let it go. One more for good measure. Press into the hands. Inhale, rise up. Good. Lift that head. Yes. Exhale down. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Bring the hands back underneath your shoulders and tuck the toes. Press back up into your plank. And then our first downward facing dog. Exhale, lift the hips high to the sky. Exhale, reach the heels to the earth. And just pedal the feet here, loosen up the head. Can you play a little bit? See how that feels? Good, and let's take a spinal wave. Inhale, lift through the heels, lift through the belly, roll back to your plank. Nice and strong. Then rock to the tips of your toes, yes. Then lower the body down as one. Woo, all the way to the mat. Release the feet. Good, y'all. Inhale, lift up, cobra or upward facing dog. If you're in your upward facing dog, lift through the kneecaps, then roll through the feet. Exhale, downward facing dog. It's definitely not summertime, but we can pretend. Childish Gambino. Inhale, lift that right leg up. Three-legged dog, nice and strong. Exhale, right knee to right elbow. Good. Inhale, lift up, three-legged dog. Exhale, right knee to left elbow. Yeah, here we go. Three-legged dog, inhale, reach. Exhale, bring the right foot in between the hands. Woo! Nice, drop the back knee. Soften the shoulders, reach the arms up, low crescent lunge. Exhale, hands to prayer. Yeah, you're gonna take that left elbow. Reach over, hook over the right thigh, press the palms together. And try to look up towards the sky. Woo! I haven't done this one in a while. So ideally, you'd like to push so that your hands are in the middle of your heart. Then exhale, hands back down to the earth. Pick up that back foot. And then take that right foot, meet me back in downward facing dog. Pedal the feet. Make sure your hands are in the same line. Make sure the fingers are spread wide. Here we go, left side. Inhale, lift that left leg up nice and high. Three-legged dog. Exhale, left knee to left elbow. Nice, inhale, lift up, three-legged dog. Exhale, left knee to right elbow, hold. Good, y'all. Inhale, lift up, three-legged dog. Exhale, bring the left foot in between the hands. Woo-hoo-hoo. Drop the back knee. The arms up. Breathe. Exhale, hands to prayer. All right, you're gonna hook that right elbow across the left thigh and twist. See how far you can go? It's been a while for me, so I'm gonna be kind to my body. Nice, inhale, reach. Woo-hoo! Exhale, hands to the floor. Step back, downward facing dog. Pedal the feet. Bend the knees here. Walk or step or hop your feet to meet your hands. And grab the elbows. Rock side to side. Notice what you feel in the back of your legs. Take your head yes and no. Woo. Bend the knees here and then slow. Roll up through the spine. All the way to Tadasana. Shake it out. Nice, y'all. Thumbs up, you doing okay? Perfect. I'm gonna blow up my candle because it's making me sweat a little bit. All right, meet me at the top of your mat. Roll out the wrist if you need to. Always trying to figure out the best angle with the laptop. All right, spread the toes, feel into all four corners of your feet. Let's play with some balance, some calf raises. So you're just gonna lift your heels up. Feel free to bring the arms with you. Find your core, find your stability. Exhale, slowly lower down. And if you need some assistance, maybe you hold on to something. Two more, inhale, lift up, calf raise. Nice and strong. Exhale, slowly lower down. Again, inhale, reach up, rise up. Find your balance. And exhale, slowly control down. Good, shake it out. Amazing. Let's do a half sun salutation here. Inhale, lift up to the sky, reach. Exhale, swan dive, forward fold. Head is the last thing. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Hands on the shins or the thighs. You got it. Lengthen through the neck. Exhale, release. And the knees inhale, root to rise. Exhale, hands to prayer. Good, let's do that again. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Exhale, release, forward fold. Bend the knees. Inhale, root to rise. Exhale, hands to prayer. Good. You're going to bring the hands behind your lower back, clasp the fingers like this, whatever feels good. And I'm going to lengthen through the spine, lift my chest. And then I'm going to exhale, allowing for forward fold over. Breathe. Can you let go? Keep a soft bend in your knees. Shift your weight to your toes. Let the neck be loose and heavy. Good. Exhale, release your hands to the earth. Ooh. All right, I'm going to do a nice spinal twist. Okay, I'll walk you through it. I'm going to bend the right knee and straighten the left leg. Bend the right knee, straighten the left leg. Bring your right hand on the earth, right in front of your face. And you're going to reach the left arm up to the sky for a nice twist. Lift up to the sky, breathe. Nice. Reach, exhale, slowly come back down through center. Bend the left knee, straighten the right leg, left hand to the earth. Twist the other way. Good, and slowly come back. Bend the knees here. Whoo, slow roll up through the spine, stacking the vertebrae. Go and shake it out. Maybe do a little of this. Twist the arms. Keep your knees and hips forward. All right, let's continue in our flow. We'll do our first sun salutation. Inhale, reach up. Scoop it up. Exhale, forward fold, all the way. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Yeah, exhale, hands to the floor. Step or hop your feet to your plank. Nice. Now, yogi's choice to do full Chaturanga Dandasana. You can always skip it and go straight to downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, bring the right foot in between the hands. Rise up to your first high crescent lunge. So just find this, keep your hips square. Pull up in the front body. Options for your arms, you can be here. Cactus, maybe hands to prayer. Breathe, really press into the mat. Hang here for a few breaths. Good. Now we're going to do the same twist we did earlier when we were in low crescent lunge. So I'm going to lean forward. I'm going to take that opposite elbow to the opposite knee. Press palms, twist, reach, breathe and hold. If you'd like to fully extend the arms up, you have that option as well. Slowly release, hands to the floor. Step back, downward facing dog. Hello, feet. Breath in and out. Allow the shoulders to travel down the back. Here we go. Inhale, lift the left leg up nice and high. Exhale, bring the left foot in between the hands. Any lyrics on this? Find your high crescent lunge. I'm gonna slowly rise up. Yep. Here, woohoo. Find your balance. So here, you don't want to be leaning forward. You want to scoop up in the front body. So sometimes that means dropping the back knee and then literally moving it bit by bit. Breathe nice and strong. Feel the heat. Exhale, bring the hands to prayer. Yeah, find that nice lunge. Lean forward. Take that elbow. Hook it across. Press. Twist. Look up towards the sky. Try to pull that shoulder back, that top shoulder back, top shoulder back. Keep twisting. And release hands to the earth. Woo, step back, downward facing dog. Woo, pedal through the feet. Spinal wave, lift the heels, lift through the belly, roll back to your plank. Yogi's choice for full chaturanga dandasana. And then this time, instead of going to downward facing dog, drop the knees to the earth, then push back. Ooh, what a child's pose. Bringing the arms behind you, resting your forehead on the mat. Let's spend a few breaths there. Release. Amazing. I'm going to try and play some non-mainstream music because, you know, YouTube, you wanting to pull stuff off. Let's take a few breaths here. Notice what you feel. Letting go of any tension. Breathing in, breathing out. Soften in the jaw. Enjoying your child's pose, releasing the shoulders. All right, slowly drag the fingertips back underneath you and then slowly press up. Yay! And meet me in your hero pose. Find that nice long spine. Allow the shoulders back and down. Take a few breaths here, feeling nice and tall. Roll the wrist, give some love. Cool. Then we're gonna take our imaginary bed sheet. You're gonna flick the bed sheet wherever your hands land. Get me back into a plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, bring the right foot in between the hands. Rise up, high lunge. Then exhale, bring the hands behind the back. Clasp the fingers. Pull it away from you. Lift up with your chest. Can you find this opposition of being in a lunge and lifting up through the chest? Good. And then slowly release, hands back down to the earth. Step back, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the left leg up so you can go a little bit further, 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 further. Exhale, bring the left foot in between the hands. Lift up, high crescent lunge. balance here. Feel the strength in your legs. Exhale, bring the hands behind you. See if you can have your other thumb on top for this. Pull down and back, lift up through the chest. Release, exhale, hands back down to the earth. Step back to your plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, bring the right foot in between the hands. This time, you're gonna come into a warrior one. So you're gonna pivot that back foot so that the toes are a little more diagonal. And you're gonna rise up. So in warrior one, your hips are squared off to the top of the mat. So really, the only difference is the back leg. So wherever your knee is, you want your toes to be. I'm gonna do the same variation we just did. Bring the hands behind you. Inhale, lift up through the chest. This time we're gonna take humble warrior. Exhale, lead with the chest. Come to the inside of that front thigh. Feel the stretch of the back of the legs. Feel the sensations here. Nice and strong. Inhale, slowly rise up. Wah! Now you're gonna turn that back foot back to a lunge pose. Good. And then exhale, take the twist, right arm up to the sky. Exhale, hands back down to the earth. Step back, downward facing dog. Oh, breathe. Feel the difference in your legs. Same thing, other side. Inhale, lift the left leg up. Up, 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 up. Exhale, bring the left foot in between the hands. Pivot the back foot so that you meet me in warrior one, other side. So the heel is down in warrior one. Hips are squared off to the front. Breathe. Draw the rib cage in. Exhale, this time, see if you can take your other thumb on top. Pull down, lift up through the chest. Exhale, humble warrior, lean forward. Draw the navel in, come to the inside of the thigh, reach the arms as far back as you can go. Press through the feet, lift away from the mat. So there's this energetic exchange here. I'm not completely chilling, I'm activated here. One more breath. Inhale, lift up, turn the back foot so that it's in a lunge. Exhale, hands to the earth. Step back to your plank, drop the knees down, draw the elbows in, and let's just take 5 half push-ups, chaturanga push-ups. Pressing down, inhale, lift up. Woo, 4 more. 3 more. Good, 2 more. Half push-ups or full push-ups, up to you. Even though I'm doing a half push-up, I still feel it. Then exhale, lean back. This time, take your knees as wide as the mat. Bring your toes to touch, sink the hips back. Extended child's pose. Let go, soften. Give your wrist a little break. Notice what you feel. Good, slowly walk it up. Nice. You're gonna swing your legs around. I'm just gonna turn this way so you can see me. Meet me in your butterfly. So soles of the feet together. You can have your feet closer to the screen or closer to you. And then if you have blocks or blankets, you can also, I used to do this in class with y'all. Bring your soles of the feet on top of the block. Go a little bit deeper and reach forward, grabbing whatever is available. Finding a few breaths here. Feeling the heat in your body, the energy, the breath, softening any parts of the body that built up some tension. Good. Inhale, slowly rise up. Nice. Can you extend one leg out to the side? If you have a block, remove it. Bring the sole of the foot into that thigh. I'm gonna keep my hips square here. And I'm gonna kind of lean towards the leg. I'm gonna take a little side stretch here, like this, yep. If you need some guidance, you can grab a block on actually the outside of the leg here. Woo, keep the sit bones down. Reach. Inhale, lift up. Then, same type of action, but you're gonna turn towards the leg. So my hips have to move a little bit. And now I'm gonna reach up and towards the leg. So you can deepen the stretch. Sometimes you can place a block behind the foot and I pull the block into the foot and it activates it a little bit more. Or you can put the block on your leg to hang out, up to you. Let go. Good, slowly rise up. Yeah, other side. Extend the other leg. Bring the foot into the thigh. Hips are facing front and side body stretch. Other side.
I never hated nobody from the West Coast. It was a personal.
Breathe.
You know what I'm saying? And I figure like this. That man.
Peel open the ribs.
We just need to just let that be it. I kind of recognize the power that me and Tupac had.
And exhale slowly, gently. Carry yourself up.
West Coast beef. I mean, that's
and now we're going to do the same thing. Turn towards the leg. Inhale, reach. Exhale, forward fold. Press through the foot. Feel that stretch in the back of the legs. Hang out here for a little bit. More breath. Good. Slowly. Rise up. Wah! Hopefully you feel a little taller. Nice. So, bring your feet to the mat. Sit nice and tall. And we're just going to slowly lean back all the way to the mat. Good. So I'd like to take supported bridge here. If you don't have a prop, that's okay. But keep your feet parallel. Keep your heels underneath your knees. Can you inhale? Lift the hips up high to the sky. Feet are parallel, pressed into the floor. Maybe you scooch your elbows underneath, grab the hands under. So you can take this, or if you have a block nearby, you place it where your belt would be. Just kind of undoing all the doing. Take a deep breath in. And out. Enjoying our practice. Are you fully present or are you thinking about what's next? Can you stay with me just for a few more minutes, savoring the last 5 minutes of this practice? Not letting anything take away from this experience. If you're here on a block, feel free to bring your legs up and take supported legs up the wall. If you're near a wall, you can actually get up against the wall. great for blood circulation. Good one to do at night. Breathe in, breathe out. Good, exhale, bend the knees. Drop the feet. If you have a block, slowly remove that. And lower down to the earth. Ooh. Hug your knees into your chest, reach for the elbows, rock side to side. Let your head go with it too. See what that feels like. Take your feet up to the sky. Happy baby, bring the hands on the outside of the feet or the ankles, whatever's available. Pull the knees down and rock side to side. Good, release the feet. Hug one knee in, roll that ankle. Flex and point through the feet. And then take a supine twist, opposite hand to the knee. Pull it across, look opposite direction. Let that shoulder drop into the earth. Undo the doing. A little bit more. All right, slowly slither back underneath yourself. Bring the hips back underneath you and switch other knee into the chest. Extend the other leg out. Ooh, roll the ankle. Reverse. Flex and point through the foot. Take opposite hand to the knee, supine twist, other direction. Look over the opposite shoulder. Relax in the face, the jaw, let the knee drop. Let the shoulder drop. Deep breath in and out. Soften, let go. And then slowly slither back to center. Take any other stretch. Make some noise, reach, pick up space, meet me in Shavasana, corpse pose, lay down, use a blanket, use a block, close your eyes, relax. We'll just hang out here for 2 to 3 minutes. I'll get you out on time. Don't skip Shavasana. It's the most important part. It seals it all together. Seals the envelope. Just tune in. How do you feel versus 45 minutes ago? Perhaps a sense of accomplishment, some endorphins. Maybe some gratitude. Can you trust yourself for the rest of the day? Anything else we got left on the agenda is already taken care of. Let's just leave it. Deep breath in, deep breath out, start to close. Maybe rocking the head left and right. Taking a yawn. Rolling the ankles and the wrists and the feet. And then when you're ready, roll to one side, fetal position. This feels good. Before you get too cozy, press yourself up. All the way to seated. And before you go, let's finish how we started. Taking any neck stretches, anything else that the body needs. Closing the eyes. Let's seal our practice with three consecutive big juicy breaths. So just inhale through the nose. Exhale, sigh it out. Two more. Inhale through the nose. Exhale. Last one. Exhale. Thank you for this practice, for moving with me. It's always an honor to move with you. Take this with you off the mat, and I'll see you next week. Namaste.